Welcome to the Beyond the Press channel.
Hello.
Today we are going to make giant air cylinder, or it's going to be like mix between cylinder and air cannon, and we are going to use it on our Smashinator 5 million and Puncher 5 million machines. And first I was planning to order some expensive pipe for the thing, but then I found this from our yard. It's old roll for some machine. I have no idea where it came, but it has been laying here probably like 5 years at least, because it's already like growing all kind of stuff. So I'm going to use this, and then we need the piston also, and I'm not sure if we can find also the piston from here, or should we need to go to Rautasoini and buy some material. But first I'm going to saw this open so we can see what is the inner diameter and is this any good. So I have already my rope here, and now I'm going to use forklift, and we are going to get it inside to the bandsaw. Because I have no idea what is in like here, there can be like one disc here and one disc here to make it more sturdy. And we only need like 1 meter, so I'm going to probably cut like here so I get all the problems out.
So exciting!
I raised this before we revealed things.
Move the bus, move the bus, move the bus. Oh, empty.
That's actually pretty cool. Yeah, we decided to do 1 meter long barrel. All my calculations are based on that, and it looks like good length. So put this here, and then I have to move the crane to the other side so it doesn't like drop. Yeah, so everything's ready, and here we go. Check this. I'm going to start sell these for like crossfitters. This is like functional deadlift training. And then, because there is lot of noise in our factory when it's like workday, I do this by voiceover. And now we are going to start mashing the pipe, because usually when you take some like rusty old pipe, it isn't round, and then it's also rusty, so we need to make it round so we can make like piston move inside of it without any problems. And we are going to have to use the like outside support bearing on this end, which is now closer to the camera. So I start by machining the outer diameter from the pipe. It doesn't matter what size it is, but because it isn't completely round and it's so rusty, we have to make it round and smooth for the support bearing. And also it doesn't hurt to make it look a little bit nicer for our machine. So now the pipe is there. And we just pick up some tool for the lathe, and start to turn it. And I didn't choose to use coolant, So I'm going to use little bit lower speed. I think I calculated speed for 120 meters per minute. So that's bit over half that you can go with like coolant. But also because it isn't completely round and there is some shit, you cannot go probably with the full speed anyways with the tool, so this didn't take that much longer than with the coolant. And one thing also with the coolant is that it's going to make a lot of smoke because the hot shavings and stuff like that, and then the smoke just piles up in your workplace because I don't have like suction thing for this lathe. But yeah, now the outer diameter is ready and it's pretty shiny. I think I did the last cut little bit smaller feet, something like 0.3 millimeters per revolution to get little bit smoother surface. And now I'm going to take the support bearing that I'm now using away and replace it with like outside support bearing so I can machine the hole. And I put this jack under the pipe so it will stay there for a while without support bearing. So now I'm going to open all the bolts that hold the support bearing in place. And then I'm going to use the lathes, is that sled or what that is, to push it away because I have this quick movement with electric motor there. And it's really easy to push the accessories back and forward on the lathe with that, because otherwise those are quite heavy to move. And then I use the crane to get the outside bearing on between the tool holder and the pipe. Now I'm going to lower it there. And this is also this is quite time consuming thing because you have to like open the bolts and get the crane and line everything. So it's always huge pain in the ass to use that outside support bearing. And now I'm going to push it where it belongs. And then I return the center support thing and get the jack out and put the thing spinning. And while it's spinning, I'm going to put the rollers against it. I put them already quite close, so I don't have to like do much, so much of things when the thing is spinning and I have to be really careful. And what I'm doing now. Yeah, that I have to move the sled away from the center bearing. I should have probably learned these words by now. Everybody's commenting about what are the real words. But yeah, and then I put some oil there. It's usually good to put some oil between the rollers and the piece that you are working, because the rollers, they are not always like completely straight and there is some slippage happening between those and the thing that you are working. So using some oil keeps things cool and there isn't so much of friction. And now I have all the support rollers against the pipe and I just tighten them so they don't open if there is some vibration or something like that. And then it's time to get the long tool for the hole. I didn't have long enough tool that could reach from like one end all the way through, and that long tool would be also quite challenging to use because it would probably vibrate quite a lot. But I happen to have this, I think this is 70 centimeters the whole thing, and it's homemade, but it's pretty good. We have like really long ones, but the diameter on those is much larger, so I couldn't use those. I think the longest one is like 3 meters or something like that. I think I should do a video about that when we use it on next time on the big lathe. And then I started to cut, because the pipe isn't completely round. It's like shakes the tool quite much. But it went pretty well. The first cut was pretty it doesn't didn't vibrate because it wasn't cutting all the for the whole like one round, but the second cut after like 20 centimeter after start, it started to vibrate really much, and it wasn't the problem with the tool. The support bearing placement was bit poor because there was so much of like span between the chuck and the support that it got some vibrations there. But I moved the thing a little bit back and then it worked. And now I'm going to machine the other end. I'm not going to make the hole completely ready from this side because I have to weld here like attachment piece for the machine that I'm going to use the cylinder in. And also I have to weld the other end so I can attach the air hose there. So I have to probably take one cut from that end also. Maybe I should first like welded everything before I even started to machine the inner diameter, but it isn't big deal. And the shavings from the lathe, they burned to the GoPro, so the GoPro was like covered with the metal shavings, so that wasn't probably the best idea to get this picture. Yeah, but I think I end the machining part for this video here. I will do more machining next week. Now I have to do some other things, so I didn't have time to make the cylinder completely ready. And I also got the steel plates from the cutting company. They are here. And here you can see the frame when it's like ready. There is going to be also some support parts there, so there isn't every part here. But you can get quite good picture about the size of the machine. And I think it's pretty good because the size of the pipe determines the size of the tool that we can use. So I think it's going to look pretty nice. But yeah, that was all the machining for this video. So yeah, that was the workshop part. What is on your opinion about the Smashinator 5mm and the Panzer 5mm?
Your pipe is really nice.
Well said. Yeah, but I think that is all for today.
Thanks for watching.
And have a nice day. And for today's extra content, we have the snow dumping site. It looks like Mordor from the Lord of the Rings. And this is view from our living room, so not very nice. Luckily there is soon leaves on the trees and we cannot see it anymore, but now it looks really bad.